like to support the channel. Also, you can do it by way of Patreon, Anchor, the clothing store, and also the shoe shop that is listed in the comment description below. And again, thank you to any and all of you guys who have been here to support this channel during the 2+ year period. I wouldn't be able to do what I do every single day without you. Got it?
Yeah.
Well.
Post-game interview, I guess.
Yeah, a little post-date interview.
How you feeling?
This is a good spot.
Yeah, you like it?
Yeah, I really do, actually. I've never had a camera recording me during a first date.
Oh, me neither. Well, do you, like, go on a lot of first dates?
I mean, a lot of first dates and a lot of second dates.
Oh. We both really like Star Wars. We figured
yeah.
out.
Yeah, no, big Star Wars fan right here, so that makes me excited.
Huge Star Wars fan.
I have a lightsaber.
Me too.
Like volleyball, basketball. I'm gonna have to learn how to speak Spanish.
Maybe un poquito. You know what that means?
A lot. No? It means a lot.
It means a lot?
Yeah.
And you're from Greenville, so
yeah. Yeah,
Greenville, I love it up there.
I'm excited to get back for sure.
Yeah. When do you go back?
Tonight, actually.
Got it. Okay.
Literally at like 10 o'clock tonight.
You have to leave soon then.
There's priorities.
I can take you to the airport if you want.
Really?
Do you have a car here? Or?
No, I didn't bring my car with me on this trip. On the plane, it was too heavy.
They wouldn't let you put it underneath the plane?
They wouldn't.
Oh. Are you flying out of Miami?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's right here.
Really?
Yeah, I'll take you.
Okay.
I don't want you Ubering.
So his date's extended.
Like, do you have plans to come back to Miami or no?
I definitely want to come back to Miami. I got a lot of good content, but I mean, You'd be the main reason I come back.
Oh, okay. When?
I don't know. I have to look at the calendar.
I kind of want to get to South Carolina.
I'm telling you, it's different. I love it. I love it so much.
I think that's like more our speed.
Right, so we were able to see the video, right? I brought you guys a video previously about this couple, and my main point was to bring up the fact that, hey, you know, everything that you see on social media is not 100% reflective of real life. This is why it is necessary for people to go out there and actually have their own experiences. But I can clearly see, looking at a lot of the comments directly from that video, that people either just look directly at the thumbnail or people just didn't even listen to my commentary at all. I can just obviously tell. And again, like I said before, and I've stated this a multitude of times, if you are a guy directly out there and you are looking for a woman that you are interested in, you might as well just take a shot, because you don't got nothing else to lose at the end of the day. I'm just saying, you realistically don't have anything to lose. This guy here, he was interested. He saw her day one and he was like, hey, I think you're attractive. You know, I want to know if you want to go out on a coffee date. And the main thing I brought up to people before is that you have a lot of female talking heads on social media that like to direct or misdirect a lot of women, telling them what to accept and what not to accept. Right. You're literally listening to other women on how to, in a sense, attract a guy instead of listening to a guy and learning from a guy how to attract a guy. Right. The dislikes and the likes and all of these other things. Right. And I also wanted to state to people that a lot of women are listening to other women who have a ton of failed relationships, right? Ton of failures all the way through, pretty much no successes, no fiancés, no, you know, marriages, right? So this is why you see an abundance of women in the exact same pot. So this woman decided to do the opposite of what social media is telling women to do. She's like, all right, well, I'm going to accept this coffee date. I even know a restaurant that I think that we will both enjoy as well. And they went to that restaurant or that coffee restaurant or whatever. And you saw the restaurant. It looks great. They came in there casual, pretty much the same type of style of wear that they wore, you know, during the interview. And for the most part, it looked great. Everybody was ecstatic. People were smiling. People were happy. And you heard her. She was offering quite a bit. She was like, yo, hey, you know, I can drive you to the airport and, you know, a variety of other things too. I'm like, yo, if these two don't happen to get married, I don't know specifically what to tell people. Like I said, the energy, at least on video, looks pretty good. And as he stated before, they have some common interest. Even when it deals with his place back in, I think what he said, like South Carolina, whatnot or whatever. She was like, hey, the weather up there is actually pretty nice. I actually like it, you know, in South Carolina. You know, she also stated some other things that were listed. The likes and dislikes too. He was like, yo, she likes Star Wars. First of all, that is a rare, let me sit up there and make people understand. For a guy to actually legitimately find a woman that is into like some Star Wars, some Star Trek, some D&D, some Yu-Gi-Oh, Warhammer, Magic the Gathering, like I'm listing things that are into the furthest of furthest extremes, where pretty much it is a desert, and if there are women there, it is very, very rare, right? Because some women would like to sit up there and say, oh, women are interested in a lot of things, and no, actually they're not. Let's not cap, let's not start telling lies. Actually, they're not. Because even still to this day, if I want to look at a Yu-Gi-Oh tournament, there's not going to be an abundance of women that are going to be playing it, right? When I look at guys who got the placemats for Warhammer and different things, like, you're not going to see a whole host of women literally spending money to buy, you know, a lot of that stuff. You know, so again, it's a rarity. So he found a woman that is interested in Star Wars, and more than likely, if she also has some books and knows some lore, it was already going up when he stated that she has a lightsaber as well. I'm like, oh, this is something right here. I'm like, yo, y'all both can go out and to comic cons and whatnot, and y'all can literally dress up. Like, people don't even understand how hype that is for a guy. And I'm just talking about, I ain't talking about for like all the other dudes out there that's like, yo, man, I'm macho. I got like 19 jobs. I'm too busy to do all of this other chop. I ain't talking about them. I'm talking about for the average normal dudes. For us, we know how special it would be to have a significant other that is into some type of like cosplay, where it's like you can go to a Comic-Con with all the rest of the normal people. And, you know, you can just be, you know, fanning out. You know, dressing up as whatever it is that y'all like to dress up as, or even if it's not the same thing, she might be into anime or something like that, right? So she have an anime costume, you have your Star Wars type of costume, and y'all can mix and match and, you know, and do different stuff like that. Like I said, it's something that both people can enjoy and take part in. And also, it's an avenue of which, you know, some people do, you know, happen to do dates as well. Right, she might not know about Star Wars. He can take her over to the Star Wars section, teach her a little bit, get her like, you know, a history type of book or whatnot. He might not know that much about anime, right? So she could take him over to the anime section, to the manga and everything like that, and teach him and show him, you know, some of the most popular, or, you know, some of the OG animes and stuff like that. Like I said, only so few people will actually understand what it is that I'm stating, you know, at this moment in time. And for some of the people that might be a little bit weirded out, because they're like, oh man, you're doing a little bit too much of this content. I'm seeing a little bit of the same people directly up here. Well, you know, I've covered a lot of videos, a variety of videos. And, you know, sometimes I want to just showcase something that's just a little bit different. And that's it. People just out here having fun. They're not following the quote unquote social media norms and deciding that they want to go into the aspect of men versus women and women versus men and all of this other type of BS. They're just out here, just relaxed. They're comfortable. They're having fun. They're enjoying, you know, each other's time and filling out the scene and seeing, you know, where stuff can go. Like I said, in general, I wish in life more things like this would actually take place between a man and a woman, because far too long you see the exact same things on social media, which is pretty reckless, pretty dangerous, and it's pretty deceitful, where you have a lot of people being misled because, you know, so many people have had, you know, one, two, or three you know, negative or bad interactions or iffy interactions, and they allow that interaction to pretty much dictate how it is that they're going to continuously move throughout life. And not only that, you also got echo chambers, which people choose to listen to, which further direct them away and to have them do all these other types of things. And again, like I told people before, a lot of people do things out of fear. A lot of people do a lot of things out of fear, right? But again, hopefully this couple, hopefully everything works out. Hopefully everything works out. It seems like, you know, people are there, and maybe they can figure something out. I don't know. But anyways, let me know what you guys think about this video and everything that I listed in the comment description below. And as always, peace, love, and stay tuned for the next video.